Hey guys, what's up? Also Damien, why do you look so exhausted?
Because I just finished upgrading my bedroom wall.
What was wrong with your wall?
Well, my room is between the Shiro and Galaxies, and I can't sleep at night because they stay up at night having sex with their girls. God, out of all the rooms, why did I have to pick a room between two guys with a girlfriend and a wife? Come on, Galaxy. That's the third time tonight. Go to bed, dammit.
Goddamn, bruh. Why you gotta put a nigga business out like that?
Yeah. Not cool, you ass.
Well, maybe if you horny bastards weren't keeping me up at night, I wouldn't have to. Plus, I told you multiple times about that.
Glad my room is in the basement so I don't have to hear that. Oh. Well, where's Mark? I think he's in the kitchen eating all those bowls of gumbo still.
Gee, Dad, don't you think you've had enough? Plus you're using up all the good bowls making more dishes to wash.
Oh, well, where the hell is AJ? I haven't seen him all day.
That nigga's out with Cosmic again.
That's what he's been doing. He's been doing that for the last few days now.
Bruh, forget the past few days. It's been the past few weeks now.
Yashiro's right. Are they actually dating?
No, every time AJ comes home and we ask, he just says, no, we're still friends. We're just hanging out.
That sounds like straight bullshit if you ask me. No way he's spending that much time with her and not have feelings for her. I agree with Galaxy. It does sound like bullshit if you ask me.
Hell, they might as well become a couple. The way they hang out and live says it all. I know because I've known them as long as Damien and AJ has. But then again, AJ has always been shy to tell a girl how he feels. That might be the problem.
Yeah, well, AJ has to come out at some point. It's obvious that he likes her. He just needs the confidence to come out and admit it and tell her.
What the fuck is that smell? It smells like straight dry pussy and ass. The fuck do y'all niggas got going on in here?
Yashiro, we're in the kitchen and we're wondering the same thing. It fucking stinks in here.
Yeah, it smells worse than me when I ate all those chili dogs.
Damien, get your crackhead eyes looking ass out here and do something. You're half demon, so you should be able to handle this shit.
To hell with that. I'm not opening my door and letting that smell in. Have Tails create a potion or something. He's a boy genius after all.
Not now. I'm in the middle of something.
In the middle of what?
I'm doing an experiment. A very important experiment. Bruh, I know your ass ain't playing with that elastic girl lobby pillow again.
Stupid smell, stop following me. I can't even play my video games with this smell in my room. Why the hell is it lingering so much?
Well, that certainly was some good gumbo. But boy, does that spicy gumbo pack a punch in my stomach. Good thing I got it all out of my system. I'll maybe have some more later.
Well, Cosmic, that was another fun day. Wanna hang out again maybe tomorrow?
Sure, why not? I'm not really doing anything tomorrow. Plus, I've really enjoyed us hanging out these last few days.
I've really enjoyed us hanging out too. And... well... I...
what is it, AJ? You can tell me.
Well, I... oh my god! What the fuck is that smell? It smells like eggs got shoved up someone's ass and shitted on.
I don't know, but it's really burning my eyes. And it's gonna make me go nose-blind.
I don't even wanna go to my room. Cosmo, could I stay at your place for the night?
Yeah, sure. Let's just get out of here before I throw up every food I've ever eaten.
Mark, we gotta talk.
Damn it, Galaxy, what do you want? I'm trying to watch the Caps game.
Chill out, I only need to talk to you for a few seconds. Anyway, everyone in this house is starting to think you have a serious jumbo problem. Yesterday, you ate so much jumbo that your stomach got messed up and you fucked up the toilet along with the whole house with a damn butt bomb.
Sigh. I had a feeling you guys might complain about that. Look, I'm sorry about that. I guess I do have a slight jumbo problem. I'll try my best to stop eating so much jumbo. And don't worry, I'll unclog the toilet. But I'm watching the Caps game right now, so I'll do it right afterwards.
Thanks for being reasonable and understanding. Hey Cosmic, thanks again for letting me stay here last night. I just couldn't stay in that house with that smell last night. It should be gone by now, so I'm gonna head out, so I'll see you later.
Wait, AJ, yesterday you were about to tell me something. What were you trying to tell me?
Oh, that. Don't worry about it. I'm gonna go to my brother's place, so I'll see you later.
Huh? That was weird. Usually AJ tells me everything. But he seemed kind of nervous and he was blushing. I wonder what's up with him. Heh. Although he was kind of cute when he was blushing. Hehe.
Dude, you're eating gumbo again?
And bruh, you smacking loud as hell. Close your damn mouth when you eat. We can hear you from the other room.
Sorry, Yashiro. And yeah, I'm eating some gumbo. What's the problem?
We're just trying to make sure you don't overdo it like yesterday.
Ah, come on. It was just a one-time thing. It's not gonna happen again.
Oh yeah? How many bowls have you had today?
Well, I've had this bowl. And two this morning. And two more after that. And I was gonna get some more after this.
That was a one-time thing, he says.
Hey, smartass, I'm trying my best. Plus, you don't see me judging you about your chili dog addiction.
Mark, you sure as hell don't seem to be trying hard enough. It just looks like your situation is just getting worse.
Speaking of worse, seems like my stomach is having an argument with bowl number one and number two. Hey!
Yeah, bruh. Big homie Mark got a problem. That nigga needs some serious help.
Yeah. Looks like we gotta take matters into our own hands. Alright, little bro, what did you want to talk to me about? And why do we have to talk about it in my room? Well, one, I didn't want to talk about this in front of the guys, because I have a feeling they would clown me. Anyway, I wanted to ask you something. How do you tell a girl that you have a crush on them? Well, dude, I've dated about two or three girls in my school. Reason being is I rushed into all the relationships causing me to break them off. So one important thing I need to ask you is, how long have you known this girl? Well, we've been friends for like 2 years now. Well, that's good. You two know each other well. It's long enough to start a relationship. What exactly do you like about this girl? Well, I think she's cute. She has a really great personality. She's smart, and she's really nice and beautiful. Well, she sounds like the total package. Yeah, but the problem is that I don't have the confidence to tell her how I feel. I'm just too nervous. Well, dude, the thing is you just have to go for it. If you don't tell her, she might just go for someone else. It'll just give her the idea that you don't like her. You gotta shoot your shot. And plus, you know what they say. You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. That counts for asking a girl out too. But being real, you have a 50-50 chance. 50% chance you'll accept you, 50% chance you'll get rejected. But that's a chance you have to take. If you don't take the shot, your chances of getting with her will most likely be pretty low. Well, I guess you're right. I might as well go for it. Might as well get it over with. Well, Sean was really helpful. He's right. I should go for it. What's the worst thing that can happen? Cosmic, I really like you. I like everything about you. Would you be my girlfriend?
Well, AJ, I like you too much. Only as a friend. I'm flattered, but I don't like you that way. I hope we can still be friends.
Oh. Yeah. It's fine, let's still be friends. Oh, that's the worst that can happen. I can do it. Damn it, Shane, stop chewing up all the toilet paper.
Kiss my ass, X. That's for putting that terrible dog disco in my food.
What's up, AJ? You just coming back from Cosmic's place?
Yeah. You okay, dude? You seem a little sad. Yeah. I'm fine. I'm just gonna go chill in my room. That was strange. I wonder what's up with him.
Probably some shit with Cosmic. But who knows? It's probably nothing though. But anyway, the reason we down here is because the upstairs smells like pure ass. Shadow won't come out of his room because of the smell and he's being a lazy ass nigga.
Basically, we call this meeting because we're all aware that Mark has a huge Yumbo addiction and it's becoming a problem.
You can say that again. I can't even play my game in my room because it stinks so bad.
Yeah, and I'm starting to run out of air freshener in my room to block the smell.
And he's using up all the pots and bowls upstairs. And when I tried to use the bathroom upstairs, there was a shit the size of my tail clogging the toilet. Well, glad we're all on the same page. But since Nae Nae, Lilith, and Emily are all hanging out with Cosmic to get out of the house, and that walking simping period fucker Knuckles is at the gym, we have to come up with a solution ourselves.
Well, maybe we can use an old method and strain Mark with a bottle every time he picks up a bowl of Yumbo or something.
Nigga, you tryna get everybody in here chilled? If we treat Mark like a dog, he'll eat the hell out of all of us.
Maybe you guys, but not me.
Either way, it's not a good idea. We need a new suggestion.
Well, maybe we can keep Mark from eating the Yumbo by taking it away from him or destroying it.
What do you mean?
I mean, if we see Mark with a bowl of Yumbo, we knock it out of his hand or something of that nature. Anything to prevent him from eating it for a while. The lack of him eating Yumbo could tone down his addiction a little.
That seems like a simple, obvious answer, but it just might work.
Yeah, it could work. Let's give it a shot. If you see Mark with a bowl of Yumbo, get rid of it in any way possible.
What the hell? My Yumbo! It just froze! What the hell just happened?
Sorry, Mark, but your Yumbo addiction is getting out of control, so we have to take extreme measures. That's why we froze your Yumbo.
Yeah, but we're only doing this because we're your friends and we're trying to help you. You understand, right? No hard feelings.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of hard feelings.
What's up, my niggas? It's your favorite character, Yashiro. Ever been roasted? Ever seen someone get roasted? Do you wanna learn how to roast?
Well, my niggas, I'm starting a roasting class. I'll teach you niggas how to roast in a heartbeat. I'll make y'all niggas hurt somebody's feelings. Register for my roasting class at YashiroTheRoastGod.org. Or text or call the number 1-800-YASH-THE-ROASTGOD. You can take my roasting class for only $29.99. Call now or sign up now. Become a roast god.
Yash, you still never told me how much you're paying me to let you do this commercial.
Nigga, who says you was getting paid?
Dude, I'm sure as hell not letting you do this for free. Obviously that plan didn't work. Also, you guys are on your own now.
Yeah, screw you guys.
Alright, so clearly we dodged a bullet just to get hit by another one. We need a new plan.
Wait, Yashi, do you remember that Carolina Reaper prank? Oh, what the fuck is up with me? It's hotter than pussy in a pepper patch. It's not even hot outside. I think someone spiked our sodas. No shit, AJ. I can barely breathe.
You guys alright?
Does it look like we're okay, you Larry the Cable Lobster looking ass? Someone spiked our drinks with jalapenos or something.
You mean Carolina Reapers?
You did this? You gotta be shitting me. You motherfucker. Spiking my 7-Up with a Carolina Reaper is going too far.
Oh yeah, I remember that shit. That nigga Mark got AJ good with that prank. But what's your point?
Well, if you remember correctly, after that, AJ didn't drink 7-Up for a while after that. So, what you're saying is, we make Mark's gumbo so spicy that he'll not want to have another bowl for a while. Exactly, Werner.
That sounds like a good plan, but how do we get something spicy enough? Simple spice clearly isn't enough to make Mark stop.
Leave that to me. But Damien, I'll need a bit of help from you.
Oh. Okay then.
Dude, do you hear that? AJ's phone has been going off all day, and it seems like he hasn't responded to any of his texts or calls.
Yeah, I've known AJ for years and I have to say, that's really out of character. Plus, I don't think I've seen him come out of his room to eat in days. The only time he leaves his room is to use the bathroom. I really hope he's okay.
AJ, why aren't you talking to me? I'm worried about you. Please call or text me back, please.
Well, this gumbo is really coming together. I can taste it already. Hopefully this time it doesn't get frozen again. But I guess I'll go in my room and have some dip before I eat.
All right. He's gone. Now it's time to start the next part of the plan. Spicing up the gumbo.
Tails, are you sure putting this in his gumbo won't kill him?
Yes, I'm sure my concoction isn't fatal. Reason being is I stupidly tested it on myself. That's why I was screaming for so long yesterday when I finished making it.
Ah, okay. Well, put it in there. He'll probably be back to check on it soon.
All right, there we go.
All right. But you said you needed me for something. What did you need me for?
Well, for one, I need you to add your flame to this gumbo.
All right then.
Okay, now I... Well... Now the gumbo needs... demonic urine.
Wait... What? You mean demon piss? You need me to piss in the gumbo? Why?
Well, the concoction needs something to make sure it's 100% effective, and demon urine seems like it's the best fit.
Sigh. Fine. But if Mark happens to ask, you're explaining this to him, Mr. Boy Genius.
Guys, have you heard from AJ? Cosmic just called me saying she hasn't heard from him.
Well, we know he hasn't left the house, but we haven't seen him in days.
Yeah, he's rarely come out of his room.
Well, she said he hasn't called her to hang out or anything or responded to her texts. She said it's been going on ever since that day after he spent a night at her apartment.
Well, that is strange for him. I wonder what's going on with him.
Yeah, also, where is my dad?
He's making a bowl of gumbo at the moment.
Seriously? I thought you guys said you were gonna do something about that.
Don't worry. We have a plan currently in progress.
Yeah. After this plan, Mark won't be eating gumbo for a while.
Well, this gumbo looks done and delicious. But I'll have a little sample just to make sure.
Yep. It's good and tasty. And it's a little spicy. Wow. That is really spicy. Wow, that's very spicy.
Holy shit, that's being fucked in the ass by another piece of shit that is spicy. I know I didn't put that much spice in here. Someone spiked my gumbo. I feel like I'm gonna... I'm gonna...
Mm-hmm.
Hey, AJ. Grab him something to eat. I haven't seen you in days.
Huh?
He just walked away. I wonder what's up with him.
Cosmic, I don't know why AJ isn't texting you, but I'm telling you he's not hurt or anything. He's here at home but hasn't come out of his room according to the guys. Well, I'm glad nothing happened to him, but still, it still makes me worried that he's not responding to me. I really just want to hear his voice. I really want to talk to him. Cosmic, I'm sure he's fine. I don't know why he's not responding, but I'm sure he's okay. But Cosmic, the way you're talking about him makes it seem like you have a crush on him or something. Wait. Cosmic, is that why you're so worried about him? Do you like AJ? Hello? Cosmic? Are you still there? Wow, she hung up on me. Well, what did she say? She was explaining how worried she was about AJ. Then I asked if she liked AJ, then she sounded nervous and hung up. Well, her having a crush on him would explain why she's so worried. And the fact that she hung up after you asked that question says that she does have a crush on him. Well, we gotta get her to confess to AJ. But then again, we gotta get AJ to talk to us and her. We gotta figure out what's bothering him.
Hey, Mark. How you feeling, big old me?
I'm feeling a lot better. But I'm going on a Yumbo-free diet for a few days. Hopefully this helps tone down my Yumbo addiction. I know one of you guys had something to do with that spicy Yumbo yesterday, though.
Sorry, Mark, but we had to get you to slow down your Yumbo addiction some way.
I guess it's fine. You did help me a bit. But anyway, do you guys know what's up with AJ? I tried to talk to him in the kitchen, but he just looked at me and walked away.
We don't know, Mark. He's been like that for the past few days. Also, Werner told me that he's been receiving texts and calls but not answering them.
Okay, that's absolutely not normal for AJ. We gotta find out what's going on with him. He just seems so sad lately.
Yeah, usually he would always play Smash Brothers with me when I asked him. But when I asked him the other day, he ignored me. It's very strange.
Well, who was the last person to talk to AJ? Maybe he's sad about something someone told him.
Guys, we gotta talk.
What is it, my pumpkin spice latte?
Well, we just got off the phone with Cosmic and she was explaining how much she's been worried about AJ. Yeah, and Maymay asked her did she like AJ and she just got nervous and hung up. That might explain why she's been so worried about him. Yeah, so that explains a lot. She also said she hasn't talked to him since he left her apartment and headed to his brother's house.
Well, if Sean was the last person to talk to AJ, he might know what's wrong with him. He's his brother after all. I'll give him a call.
Alright, what do you guys want? Why are we outside? And most importantly, why did you interrupt my win streak at the casino?
Dude, now's not the time for gambling. Anyway, we called you because something has been going on with your little brother, and we were told you were probably the last person he talked to, so you might know what's up. And the reason we're meeting outside is because we don't want AJ to hear your voice and asking questions, because he might just throw a fit. But anyway, Sean, what did AJ go to your place for?
Well, he asked for advice about asking a girl out. I just told him that he should shoot his shot, and if unfortunately he happens to get rejected, he has to accept it and move on. But I also told him he has a 50-50 chance.
Oh wait, I think I know what it is now. The rejection part. AJ is afraid of getting rejected. Even though he really likes Cosmic, he has a fear of getting rejected, and that's why he's been upset. It all makes sense now.
Yeah, I get it. I was like AJ before. Rejection hurts, but it's better to try than to not try at all. That nigga just gotta go for it.
AJ likes Cosmic? Well, I'm not surprised. They would make a good couple.
Yeah. But AJ getting rejected at this point isn't likely. As we heard, Cosmic clearly likes AJ too, but she's too shy to admit it, obviously. We gotta get those two to talk, but AJ said, and Cosmic is shy.
Well, our next course of action is obvious. We just gotta get those two to talk to each other and come out about how they feel. But how?
Well, we could get them to go back to the place where they first met. They had a lot to talk about then, before Cosmic's boyfriend came. Me and AJ were having bro time that day. Sounds like a plan. But how do we get AJ out of his room? Well, I could call AJ and tell him that we should hang out to have some bro time.
But AJ hasn't been answering his phone.
Nah. Don't worry. Anytime I call, AJ always answers no matter what mood he's in.
Also, Nene, don't you have Cosmic's number? How about you call her and tell her you and the girls are gonna have a girl picnic at that spot?
Yeah, I can do that, no problem.
Well, looks like we have a plan. We'll do it tomorrow. Reason that we're doing it tomorrow is because it's too late to do it now. Plus, I have a casino winning streak to keep tonight. See ya later.
Hello?
Oh, hey, bro. Bro time? Well, I have been a bit down lately, so I guess I will.
Alright.
Okay, I'll start getting ready. Bye. Well, Sean wants to have some bro time. Maybe this will cheer me up a bit.
Dude, who are you texting?
Oh, don't worry about it. Just listen to the radio while I drive. Just not trying to get into a car accident like last time. Don't worry, it's not gonna happen again. Trust me. Oh yeah, I trust you alright.
Hey. I remember this place. We came here to chill a few years ago.
Yeah, I figured we'd come here today for old time's sake. Anyway, I'm gonna set stuff up. How about you go chill out by the lake over there? I'll come get you when I'm done.
Alright, bro.
Well, this place is just as nice as it was 2 years ago. Brings back memories.
Huh? AJ? What are you doing here? I haven't heard from you in days.
Oh, I'm here with Sean. He wanted to have some bro time today. I'm sorry that I haven't been texting you back or calling back. I've just been a little upset.
Upset about what?
Don't worry about it. I think Sean is done. I'm gonna head back over to him.
AJ, no. You're my best friend. And best friends talk things out. You have to tell me what's up. I'm not gonna leave you alone until you tell me.
Sigh. I guess you're right. I should tell you about it. It's not gonna help if I keep hiding my feelings. Cosmic.
I really like you. Like you. I think you're smart, Sully, very pretty, with a really amazing personality. The reason I didn't tell you is because I talked to Sean and he told me about rejection and it would've been really hard to digest if I told my best friend that I had a crush on her and she rejected me. I'm sorry I haven't been texting or calling you back, but the thought of you not liking me back that way just really bothered me.
I really like you too. I like your personality, how funny you are. I love your style, and I think you're really cute. I've been really shy to tell you.
Oh. Well.
Cosmic, would you be my girlfriend?
Only if you'll be my boyfriend. Wow.
Deal.
When it gets dark outside, in you I confide. You help me face my demons, I won't hide, hide. Girls like you are hard to find. I hope you don't mind if I give you the time of your life, life, life. I found my home, shorty make me feel at home. She made me leave the thrills at home, and I'm fine with it. She really made me lose control. I'ma let my love unfold. We're just two lost souls, but we're fine with it.
Life is not the same with your pictures in my frame.
Goddamn, I knew that jungle was spicy, but I didn't know it was that spicy.
Dad, don't forget to unclog the other four toilets.
God damn it.